morning, students. We need the web applications, but first of all, we move towards the web application. We should know what are the existing technologies and what are the limitations of these technologies. So, firstly, I will move to the console based application, then to the desktop based application, then come to the web application. At least, first of all, we should know what is the console based application. Console based applications are those applications that can be take the input from the command prompt, where user can take the inputs from the command prompt and display the output on the command prompt. For the example of the desktop console based applications is, for example, C and C++, and many more also like Java, where we can take the input from the console based. But the problem in this kind of the applications, we cannot use on internet. So this is the limitations of the console-based application. And one more thing is, in console-based application, we do not use the graphicals. So if we want some graphics, then we have to move the desktop-based application or window-based applications. If we are talking about the desktop-based applications are those that are already installed on the desktop. If it is already not installed, we cannot use that. And again, the one more thing is there is no need of the internet. And in nowadays, the customer requirement or the client requirement is, there is no restriction should be there. We want to move anywhere 24/7. And both such kind of the applications, there is no need of the internet, and through internet, we cannot use these kind of the applications. So, in now era, we have the web. Web is 24/7, we can use. Or anywhere we can use, user cannot restrict it that you have to install such applications or you have to use this particular system that is already installed. So through web, we can use any kind of the application from anywhere in the world. Next, for designing the web pages or for designing the web application, we have to use some web technologies languages. In such of that, HTML is one of the language, and by using of the HTML, we can design the web pages. So, with the help of the HTML pages, we can design a web page, or that particular page will be run over the web browser, and web browser will display the output, and we can see what is the HTML. And this is the simplest architecture of the HTML web page, through in which started from the HTML tag, and it will have the two sections. First is head section, and second is the body section. In the head section, we can put some meta information related and all those things. But this particular part is not displayed over the user. So if we want some text and that, so we can use the body part. In body part, contains only those things where user put these things, and user can see the output over the web browsers. And this particular HTML save with the .html file over the notepad. When we write something and then save it .html or .html and then run over the web browser. We can use any web browser, the Internet Explorer, other Safari, other Chrome, other Google, and so many different kind of the web browsers. But the restrictions is there. This particular language is only the interpreted language. And interpreted language is not if this particular text, in this particular individual line by line we can interpret, it should not be used by any compiler. So the thing is this one, and one more restriction in the HTML is this one, through which we can develop only the static web pages. If we want dynamic pages, then we have to use DHTML. And DHTML is what? Dynamic HTML. HTML is stand for Hypertext Markup Language. Hypertext means a text which is linked to the another text. And markup means just mark that particular text which we want to display. For example, if suppose we want a text, hello, and this particular text should be displayed in bold letter, then through HTML tag, the bold tag we can use inside the text. If we want this particular bold tag, then the output will be in the bold letters with the help of the HTML language. So the full form of HTML is Hypertext Markup Language. Hypertext means linking or navigation, and markup means a particular text which we mark. we what we want kind of the output. So if we are talking about the DHTML, DHTML means dynamic HTML. In this dynamic HTML, we will use different kind of the technologies or language. For example, CSS is also there, HTML is also there, and JavaScript is also there, and many more. Through which we can design dynamic, not static website. CSS is stand for cascading style sheet. HTML we already discussed, and JavaScript for the validation purpose and for some dynamic things. So, including these technologies, we can design some dynamic web pages with the help of DHTML. Thank you, and we will discuss it later.